The coilovers also need refurbishment, so I use a spring compressor to do exactly that. And once the spring is compressed enough, the retainer can be removed, and I can separate the springs that I'll keep from the shocks that I won't. All this mucky gear gets a mega clean in my parts washer, and they come out looking a whole lot better. I also need to smarten these up. The drive shafts need to be thoroughly cleaned because here comes the stone chip to make them look more presentable. There's also an extra layer of protection from the elements. Now, I've got a little bit of a problem here. Now, you can see that the ends or the fingers on the end of my spring compressors, if I was to put them back into this side of the spring, they might actually foul on our brand new shock absorber. That would be a bit of a shame. So I need to come up with a way of stopping that being a problem. And rather than rushing out and spending a load of money on a new spring compressor, I thought I'd kind of get a little bit busy in here and work out a little solution around it. So what I've done is I've extended some exhaust clamps using some studding. And I just hook that either side, a bit of tubing. And I'm hoping now what will happen is I can still compress the spring and actually then get this little cap in the right position. So here we go. I've already established that the shock absorbers are past saving, so I've purchased a new set for £350, and these are a better spec than the originals. So we now have a spring in position, but you might notice this little red castellated nut at the bottom here. The idea of that is to kind of pre-tension the spring, and the more tension there is in the spring, the higher the car is going to sit, or at least the wings above the wheels. So what I want to do is just put a little bit of preload in just to make sure that it actually sits just about right, and obviously we can set it up properly later on, or at least certainly before we go for a test drive. The preload settings are available from TVR resource pages online if you want to do the same, or a specialist will ask about £100 for a setup. To be honest though, if it looks right, it probably is.